Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Asad Yaqub with the review of 23rd May IELTS test. So many of you were asking me to make a video on 23rd May IELTS test, what is going to happen and all that. So here I am with that view. Well guys, once again, as usual, I'm in the lawn of my house and from here I'm making this video. You can see the beautiful flowers here and yeah, all of them. And this is for the first time that I'm using my gimbal. So my experience with gimbal, let's see how does it go. You have to tell me all that. As far as 23 May IELTS test is concerned, it is going to be a complete test, a full test. Full test means it's going to be academic and general training together. So those who are planning to take it, be ready whenever, as I told you before, whenever there is the IELTS test, academic and general training together, it's comparatively easier in listening. Okay, so let's see this time what happens, if it is easier in listening or not. Anyways, as far as the listening is concerned, what I believe on 23rd of May, listening is going to be moderate. It's not going to be very difficult, it's going to be moderate. Moderate means one section can be difficult, or maybe few questions can be difficult, but otherwise section 1 is going to be pretty easy, section 2 will be pretty easy, and for some students section 4 is also going to be pretty easy. Only section 3 can be somewhat difficult, or some questions can be somewhat difficult. Okay. After listening, let's talk about reading. We will talk about academic reading first. As far as academic reading is concerned, academic reading is not going to be that typical on 23rd of May. Now, let me tell you what I mean by this. That typical means usually it becomes very, very, very difficult. So on 23rd May, IELTS reading, yes, I understand. One passage is going to be tough. Some questions are going to be difficult. But on the whole, it's going to be moderate. So the question type which you guys need to focus on, let me tell you, I just forgot about that. For listening section 1, you should focus questions like completion questions, form completion, table completion, flowchart completion, or any other type of completion question. So you have to focus the completion question. That is going to be one of the important types for listening. Secondly, multiple choice and map. If there is a map, there will be around 3 to 4 questions, not more than that. But for multiple choice, you guys need to pay some special attention, because in section 2 and section 3, there can be multiple choice. And by the way, let me tell you, in section 1 and section 4, there is going to be a completion question that is going to be no more than one word or no more than two words, right, like that. So this is about listening. After that, reading. I mean, the passages can be from anywhere, the nature of passages can be about anything, but the main thing is you need to read the questions, and the questions are important. Now, the type of questions which are important for academic IELTS reading for 23rd of May, the first type is true, false, not given. The second type is sentence completion. The third type is short answer question. The fourth type is what do we call that? Multiple choice. That is going to be very, very important, right? The fifth type is matching. So these five types are going to be the very important ones for your IELTS test, especially reading. As far as general training reading is concerned, let me tell you the good news is this. General training reading section 1 and section 2, they are going to be quite easy. I mean, section 1 is not going to be anything difficult. You can do it in 10 to 15 minutes. Section 2 is not going to be difficult at all. But section 3, because there is a long passage, so section 3 can be somewhat tricky or somewhat difficult. So that's why you guys need to be ready for section 3, especially when you are preparing. You need to be ready for section 3. And the type of questions which are, which is important for 23rd May, that is finding information in the paragraphs, true, false, not given, yes, no, not given, multiple choice, list of headings. And by the way, for academic reading also, I just forgot to tell you, list of headings is another important type of questions. So for gender training, multiple choice, list of headings, sentence completion with one word, summary completion, these type of questions are very, very important. After reading, we've got writing. And as far as writing is concerned, again, I would say there are 3 to 4 types of essays which are important. Number one still is opinion essay. Number two is discussion essay. Number three is actually a double question essay, like where they say, is this a positive or a negative development? That is again an opinion essay. Or if there is a double question essay, like where they ask you 2 questions, for both questions, you got to write 2 separate paragraphs. Writing task one. For academic, again, it's going to be something like a graph with a trend or a comparative graph. But still, you need to be prepared for maps as well, because it can be a process diagram or it can be a map. So there are just 4 categories. If you prepare all, definitely you can easily go through your IELTS test, especially academic writing. Well, as far as letter writing is concerned, I would only say there are 5 to 6 types. So this time the letter writing topic is going to be very, very usual topic, very common topic. I mean, it's going to be a topic which usually comes, or a similar type of topic. So you don't need to worry about that. All you need to do, you need to focus the parts of the letter. Just see how many parts are there and how to deal with these parts of the letter. Okay, and the tone of the letter, formal, semi-formal, informal. And according to the tone, there is the beginning, ending, and the language that you use, that is also important. So this is actually my prediction for your IELTS test on 23rd of May. Because many of you are asking me, nobody was around. So this is the ice cream seller outside. Nobody was around, so I just took my gimbal. I put my GoPro on the gimbal, and here I am in my lawn making this video for you. I'll try to make more videos for you guys. So thank you very much. If you like this video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel. I run another channel, Asad Yaqub Vlogs. You can subscribe to that channel as well. And I also teach IELTS online. If you want to join my online IELTS classes, you can contact me for that. Asad Yaqub wishes you all the best from the beautiful lawn of his house. Take good care of yourselves. My sore throat. Take good care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.